Thank you for tuning in to Philly Connect. I'm your host, Mo Tilla, and today I have a comedian here from Philly, Kahlif Little. Introduce yourself, Kahlif Little.
What up? Kahlif Little, better known as comedian, actor, skit, all that. You know, come on.
Okay, you do a lot, I see. So tell us a little bit about yourself, Kahlif. I know you're from Philly. I know you, but you know, maybe you are from Philly.
Born and raised Philly. No matter what part I'm living out of it, you know what I'm saying? Like, comedy for me, like, you know, it wasn't never a plan. Something that just happened. Like, I get my hair cut and brush on the toilet. It's like, my manager, slash barber, his name's Ryan, I was in. He cut a lot of, he a celebrity barber.
Okay.
So just one day in the barber shop,
talking about talk. Just getting a cut one day.
Just one day getting a cut, going in the shop, talking about normal.
Shaking how much stuff.
No. That ain't even happening. The shop is pretty much like a stage. So just like you go to the hair salon like with Jerry, I'm not talking about everything.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? The barbershop is the same thing for guys. So
yeah.
It was just that. It's that day, Rick was there getting the cut, and he couldn't get his hair cut. He did some slabs. So the next day, he called my phone and was like, come open up for us at the
house. Word. Okay.
Word. And I'm like, he playing on my phone. Like, come open up for us at the house. And I'm like, yo, the power, dog, I don't never did stand up.
Right.
Instead of running people. Never, like, I talk my shit in the hood. Like, you be around me, like, we have fun at our get togethers. We do what we do.
You know, you be in house funny.
Yes.
So
like, you know, to go on stage funny is a whole different ball.
Absolutely.
And just from there, like, it just became a drug.
Okay, so it kind of came next to you after you got on that stage. How did you get a puzzle, though? You get a boom?
No.
Sandman come out?
No. I ain't come out. But you know, I did my thing. I held it down for it. Being my first time on stage, I didn't know what's up there. I'm not sure you were working this thing.
Okay, so you were a freestyle comedian?
No, not really. I have my power, I say my strongest attribute in the comedy industry is like I can react real quick, I can think good on people.
Okay.
So that's me on stage. Like if something's not working for me, I can automatically go to something else that I know will work.
Okay. So we have a lot of local comedians, I feel like, of course, everybody you know recognizes Philly. It's kind of hard. They really do with Philly. You got a comedian spinning up there, you got your Lawrence Philly group.
Charles my best man.
And of course, and how do you set yourself apart from, you know, these local comedians that's up and coming now and that's out there trying to get to it? How do you set yourself apart from it?
I mean, like me, being though it wasn't planned, like I'm just me. I don't try to be like in other words, you know, other people go out there and do these comedy shows. They try to be something that they're not. Me, what you see is what you get.
Okay.
Like, you know, like what you see is what you get. Like, I'm not faking. You know, I have a lot of people, you know, a lot of every time I get on stage, a lot of people always compare me to Kevin Hart. Like, and at first, I used to take that more personal, so I realized I committed it to him. So
right.
I can joke about anything he wants.
Yeah, they can get compliments.
At the same time, but I never looked at it like that. So, like, for me, I fit in, I'm in my own. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't trying to be like nobody. I ain't got no beef with nobody. Like, I get put on shows, I'm coming to fuck it up and leave.
Okay.
That's.
You know, I gotta take this shit so bad. I should be having you lean up like this. Man, you gotta hurry up. I gotta take a shit.
Come on.
You gotta get there. It's like I got shot.
It is not like you got shot.
I got a turtle head. It's right at the butt.
So, alright, so you got a lot of confirmation. You've been doing it for, I mean, I've been to a few of your shows. I've seen some skits in that. So, I mean, me, you funny. You know. Even though you're family.
To each his own. But see, that's the one thing that I mean, like, I love about y'all. Like, you already know. Y'all keep, we keep it mean with each other.
Absolutely.
It's not funny. Y'all want to tell
me. Well, I'm going to tell you. I'm going to give you some insight.
That's not working. So, like, I haven't came to me with that. It's not working yet. So, like, you know, I'm just, you know. And plus, you know, I got God on my side, man. You know, before I went on stage,
I talked
to him. You know what I'm saying? Like, at the end of the day, man, like, I'm chasing my dream. You know, I'm turning dreams into reality.
Yeah, you should.
I just do it for my family.
I know, that's right. So give us a little bit of a resume for us. How many shows have you done? Have you done any movies? Got any scripts going on? Tell us a little something.
There's a lot going on, man. Well, I started off at El Palo. Now I got a company in there with one of my people, Mike Sportman. I was one man. We put on a show in Japan, Paris. Did over 10, 15 shows in the home. And that led to, you know, me doing an interview for Michael Blackson. Queen Montana over here. Did that. That popped off real good. And then, you know, from there, it was just stage to stage, city to city. I've been a lot of places.
Okay.
Vegas, LA, New York.
New York. you didn't show up.
Like my thing is this, like nobody's gonna give you nothing. I have a saying, nothing's given, everything's earned. But I mean that, what I mean by that is people are scared. Anytime I'm in the town doing anything, I'm always looking for scarcity. There's always opportunity.
That's right.
So therefore, like the opportunity presents itself, you just gotta go out gas and give it.
That's true. Right. So that does put a separate aside from his whole community, because a lot of people want to be sure it's responsibility. But I know sometimes you gotta take a ride. But then that bus is for the city.
See, something crazy though. What you gotta understand is like your biggest supporters in Philly, even though, like, don't get me wrong, you, family, and support, but your biggest fans in Philly or your biggest supporters be the people that y'all even know.
Absolutely.
You dig what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
But then, like, you know, that be the problem with it, because then when your name gets ringing, your name gets buzzing, that's when everybody's like, right. Ah, I was dead.
Yeah, that's called that word of mouth. That's the old school marketing. That's the word of mouth. So somebody don't know you, like, tell the next person, tell the next person, that's how you get forward. So it go from there, it go from streaming.
You already know.
Every time a nigga get in your fucking car, a nigga gotta always be like, you got a phone charger. Yeah, bitch, I got a phone charger for my motherfucking phone. Your punk ass knew last night when you went to sleep to put that bullshit ass 4S 5C on a motherfucking phone charger.
Okay, so if people wanted to go check you out, what about your Instagram, your Facebook, website, you give all the
info? Oh, man, I ain't hard to find, man. You can find me on Instagram at ExoticW2. That's ExoticW2. You can find me on Facebook as Kahlif Ali, K-E-J, L-I-F, and then Kahlif, A-M-I. YouTube, Kahlif, Exotic Weird Show. I just actually jumped into YouTube things, so I'm starting up little things and like that. But, you know, I'm not hard to find.
Okay, boo. So after this, y'all tune into this clip that we got from Kahlif Little. If you are tuning in and listening, just go to our website, www.kahlifnight.com, to check the link and tune in. Thank you for listening.
Turn up.
Yeah. Thank you guys for tuning in to Philly Connect. You can visit our website at phillyconnect.com.